those people who have miscarriages, I'm so sorry for all those people. And I always see people saying that their child was an accident, or that the pregnancy was unexpected. But I believe that pregnancy wasn't unexpected. That I believe that God changed the situation, and He had that happen for a reason. He brought this child into this world for a reason. And if you get rid of that child, that is blocking off any blessing that that child is going to bring into this new generation. Because I believe that these children that were supposed to be born, or that are being born right now, is going to be the generation that is going to, perform the most miracles.
Yes.
This is going to be the most amazing, most blessed generation that there has ever been.
Yes.
And when I heard God saying this, this just gave me chills, and I started shaking, because this is so powerful. That the fact that God was telling me that these children that were supposed to be born had a purpose, but they're not living their purpose anymore. But that is why He's bringing in more children now, bringing in more of these children that have this purpose in life. And their purpose here is to worship, be worshipers, be leaders, and be prophets, to prophesy, and to be going on missionary trips, become missionaries, to be prophets, to be all these things. These were their purposes, and this is still their purpose. And God will bring in more children this year, and then the next year, to do these things. And I believe that there will be one child, and I heard this from God, there will be one child that comes into this church. I don't know how old they are, but I know that they're younger than me. I know that there will be one child that comes into this church that is going to truly, truly bring in anointing and worship and within any ministry that is a part of this church. And I really feel like that this one child is going to help the growth of this church. And I believe that they will bring in an abundance of blessings upon everyone in this church. I believe that that child is going to be a leader in this church. I don't know who. I don't know whether it's a boy or a girl. I just know that there is going to be a child, whether they're in here right now or not, or if they're coming in next year, or, you know, if they're still growing, trying to learn how to walk right now, that they are going to be a leader in this church. And that was said by God.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Did you hear that, Pastor Chad? More children. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. All right. It's decreed from the throne. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord. You know, as Rosie's playing this morning, I can just feel in the Lord, this is a day of prophetic decree. This is a day of warfare. This is a day where God is taking us violently into this next season. And it seems like lately, in so many seasons, we've felt the violence going into the season. This season, God is having us taking the violence into this season. How many know the word says that since that time, the kingdom of heaven has been taken by force or violence, and violent saints take it. Hallelujah. Today, God's moving us violently in victory into this new season. Do you receive that today? God says, expect. He says, expect the unexpected in this new season. Hallelujah. And be willing to do things you weren't willing to do before. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
fortune lies beyond the stars. Those dazzling heights too vast to climb. I got so high to fall so far. But I found heaven as love swept low. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky when my knees hit the ground. Treasure waits within your scars. This gift of freedom gold can't buy. I bought the world and sold my heart. You traded heaven to have me again. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky when my knees hit the ground. Find me here at your feet again. Everything I am, reaching out, I surrender. Come sweep me up in your love again, and my soul will dance on the wings of forever. Find me here at your feet again. Everything I am, reaching out, I surrender. Come sweep me up in your love again, and my soul will dance on the wings of forever. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky when my knees hit the ground. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky when my knees hit the ground. Find me here at your feet again. Everything I am, reaching out, I surrender. Come sweep me up in your love again, and my soul will dance
Reaching out, I surrender.
Come sweep me up in your love again, and my soul will dance on the wings of forever. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky when my knees hit the ground. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky where my knees hit the ground.
Thank you, Jesus. Anybody enjoying the Lord out there this morning? Amen. Just such a sweet presence of God in this place. Amen. We've gone from warfare to just a in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Give life,
you are love,
you bring light to the darkness,
you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken.
Breath
in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. You only, you are loved,
you
bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. You only,
it's your breath
in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you.
Hallelujah. We're going to do one more song this morning before we go into the Word. Hallelujah. And this is just a song all about Jesus. Hallelujah. And it's a song that Miss Rosie wrote. And it may sound familiar to some. We have sung it a few times here. But it's just a beautiful, simple, extravagant song in the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, Jesus, we worship you, Jesus,
Jesus.
Jesus,
no matter the season, you are Jesus.
Oh, come, Holy Spirit, won't you fill this place?
Jesus. Jesus,
we worship you, Jesus.
Jesus,
we are healed in the name of
Jesus. Jesus,
you are Jesus.
You are Jesus. Jesus.
Oh, come,
Holy Spirit,
fill my heart with your love. Jesus, we worship you,
Jesus. Jesus,
you are worthy,
Jesus.
You are Jesus.
Jesus, you're the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. You make us hungry for more. You're the King of Kings, you're the Lord of Lords. You make us hungry for more. Intimacy, take us deeper. Wise virgins in this hour, Jesus, we release the name of Jesus over every sickness and every disease, over everything in this room that needs healing. We release the name of Jesus this morning. Jesus, Jesus, at his name demons flee, sickness is healed in his name. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, we are free. In the name of Jesus, we have sozo. In the name of Jesus is the victory. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Oh, come. oh come, King of heaven, pour out your love over us.
Yes, Lord, your love over us.
When we sing Jesus. Jesus, you are Jesus.
Jesus,
and the whole world sings, you are
Jesus.
You are
Jesus.
Jesus, you are Jesus.
Lord, you know, as we were finishing the song, I heard Micah begin to cry, and it was Baba time, and I looked over, and the bottle was one person away from him, and he's just looking at that bottle, crying, wanting that thing, man, and it can't get over to him soon enough, and this, as soon as it heads to him, man, just like a magnet to metal, he's on that thing, you know. And I just thought to myself real quickly, it might have been the Holy Spirit, but maybe not. But I'm just watching. I'm thinking, Lord, may we be that hungry for you. You know, that if you're just one person away from us, that's not good enough. Lord, we want you just right here, you know, just right on us, God. You know, and when the Holy Spirit begins to fall, may we just be, you know, just soaking in the Holy Spirit like a sponge, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, we just give you the rest of the service. Lord, I ask that your anointing would be upon my brother as he comes to speak, Lord, this morning, God. Lord, I thank you that you spoke to him about a new season. Lord, even he and Christina being here is all about a new season. So, Lord, I ask today, God, through the word that you're going to release, may you open doors and close doors. May you shift things in this word today. And Lord, may none of us leave unchanged. Holy Spirit, we give you freedom to be who you are. Lord, may you increase and may your power be released this morning in the name of Jesus. And Father, may everyone in this house feel your love in Jesus' name. For Lord, there's no other name under heaven given to men by which they can be saved but the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you today. And everybody said, amen. Woo! Glory. Lord, may the glory not leave this room. Amen. Amen.
It works. There we go. Thank you, Jesus. Can everybody hear me all right? All right. Good. It's working. Praise God. Hold on. I got my Jesus shirt on. Everybody. Yeah. They were in worship practice this morning, and I said, you know, Pastor Andrew, I think, you know, the Lord's leading me. Every time you guys say Jesus, I'm just going to, you know, flash. I was joking. But I had to do it once. You know, we made eye contact, so I had to do it one time. It was pretty good. So, as is pretty typical of Jesus, you never know what he's going to do. And I feel like today is no different. I feel like for this last season, we've been talking about revival, and we've been talking about the phrase that sticks in my mind, Pastor Andrew would say about Azusa. He said, we have no idea who's in charge, but the meeting's under control. And so I believe God wants us to practice that today, to actually take a step into that, and it's going to be a little bit different. Hence, I haven't had Rob turn the lights on. I asked Cindy to just kind of keep some worship music going in the background. And what was really on my heart was that I don't want us to go from actively engaging here to passively here, right? And as we go into this new season, the Lord was highlighting to me that we're doing it as a family. That me getting up here and releasing a prophetic declaration, it's just not his way. I don't believe that's his way to do it. And everybody follow me into the new season. No, it's he opens the door, and as a family, we all step in together, right? And so it's going to be a little different. I've already thrown my message so far out the window. I don't even remember, but if you want to talk to me about it later, I got a lot of notes. So what I asked a few people to do, and I'm going to continue to ask people to do, I spoke with some people through worship, because the Lord put Jericho on my heart this morning. And originally, my message was going to be, with my God, I can scale a wall. It was going to be out of Psalm 18. And the Lord put on my heart this morning, Jericho. And, you know, I went back here in this back room, and the Lord just had me walk in circles. And it was like, you know how a lion prowls? You know? And that's what God's been doing for this last season. He's been prowling around, right? He's the lion of the tribe of Judah, and lions stalk their prey. Can you imagine walking around the city that God promised you for 7 days in a row and just waiting for him to break through? You're waiting for him, right? And so I asked specifically three men in the church to just be kind of around the borders of the sanctuary and just to be praying continuously as we go through this message, right? And I also invited a few other people. Whatever God has on your heart today, if you feel led to share it, if you feel prompted by the Holy Spirit, and John was one of the ones that I asked, right? He may pace up here, he may go on the stage, wherever God leads him. I just want us all to be engaged today, right? So I spoke with Holly, too. As we're listening to worship, you know, we've got the Yeshua on back here. We might just turn the worship up and go right back into worship. I don't know. I have no idea what we're going to do. I don't know where I'm going to start. I don't know how we're going to end. I don't even know if I'm going to be the one speaking today. Somebody else could be bringing the word for today. It could be short. It could be long. I have no clue. But we're just here by faith, and we're here together. And I'm going to start where the Lord's put on my heart. And I just want to pray because I just feel like this is a really holy moment right now. So, Father God, I thank you that your Spirit is holy, that you've set apart this day, this moment, this hour, this minute, this second for all of us, your body, to be together in this room. God, and it wouldn't be right if just one part of our body came into this new season. It wouldn't be right if just the foot or just the hand or just the ear or just the eye came in to this new season that you have declared and decreed for today. Father, so I ask that in one spirit and one mind, one accord, one heart, one voice, we together, by your Holy Spirit, we step in today. Lord, and we give you total control. We give you liberty in this place to do whatever you want to do. Lord, minister to us. We will minister to you. We'll minister to one another. Lord, you be the boundaries of the river, and let us just flow with you this morning. So, Father, we just thank you. We bless your name. Cindy, will you just turn that up for a minute? Let's just sit and wait. He's beautiful. Fill this temple with your glory. Jesus, come. Come and deliver us, Father God. Come and heal us from sickness, from disease, from afflictions in the mind, in the soul, in the body. Come with your authority. Come with your power now. Come with the roaring voice of the lion of the tribe of Judah. Jesus. encourage you right now, together as a body, let us all play our part, one spirit, one mind, one voice, one step, all joined and knit together. Give us courage to do that which you call us to do today. Yes, God. Psalm 37. Pastor Andrew was reading this earlier. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and befriend faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Dwell in the land. Dwell in the land. Dwell in the land. This is a season to dwell in the promised land. Father, we thank you that you took us out of Egypt. We thank you that you led us to the land. You led us here today. You led us right to where we are. In our lives, each one of us, you know perfectly. You know our circumstances. God, and you brought us out. You've led us here, and you're going to take us in. You're going to take us in together as a family. You're going to take us into the promised land. You're going to take us into that place flowing with milk and honey, not because of our works, not because of our righteousness, but because of your son Jesus, because of his great love with which he loved us and laid his life down and said, come and be a part of my body, come and dwell in me, come and remain in me that you may bear fruit. Father, I thank you. This is a season of bearing fruit. Was put on my heart earlier to have our friend Carrie share a word. Is this mic on? Hello. So I'm just going to invite her up. let's all just welcome Carrie. Let's all pray over Carrie for a minute. We're just going to bless her. Everybody stretch out your hand if you can. Just pray. Pray with me for Carrie. Father, we thank you for Carrie. God, we thank you for the season that she is in. We thank you that by your sovereignty, you led her here this morning. Lord, and you gave her a word to share. So, Father, I ask like a river, it would come bubbling up out of her soul and her spirit. Lord, and that you would just bless the work of her hands and cause her to bear much fruit. In Jesus' name.
Hello, hello.
There.
Well, I leave it to the Haleys to always pull me out of my comfort zone. So I thank God for them and their friendship and for bringing me here today with my son. You know, ever since the pandemic started, we haven't been to an in-person service. So it's really great to be here today.
Yes.
So thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
And as we were worshiping, I just kept hearing, you were covered. Being in here, we're covered again. And that's not something that can happen when you're staring at a computer screen or at your cell phone. We're here and we're covered, and we're here around people who believe and feel the same way as we all do. And then watching my son worship up here, I kept seeing him covering himself with the lion and how neat that was.
Yes.
And so, yeah, we're so thankful to be here today, and I feel like the Lord was telling me that is his job, and we don't have to worry about covering ourselves, because he puts us in positions to where he will keep us covered. And this little boy, he amazes me. Every day he pulled me out of my comfort zone, because I just like to sit down and worship in my bubble, and he said, Mom, I need you up here with me. You have to wave the flag with me. He's like, I'm doing it. And he made another good point. He says, we don't know anybody here, so who cares what they think? And I feel like that's how we should live every day, just not caring what anybody thinks, but just holding the same goal in our heart. Thank you, guys.
Hey, Carrie, before you sit down, let's give her a little round of applause. Praise God for Carrie. She's awesome. Before we just continue on with whatever the Lord is going to lead us to do, anyone who feels like maybe they're coming out of a season where they weren't covered, or they really are just hungry for the Lord's covering, for his provision, for his protection, for just the fatherly, I got you, right? I'm just going to ask, you can stand, raise your hand, whatever that may be. Okay, I'm just going to ask that you would pray that over us as a body and anyone who feels that. I know I want that, for real. It's been an intense season. And for God to take me under his arm and just say, come here, son, I want that, I need that. So if you would, just pray that over us.
Lord, we just lift our friends to you. We pray that in this season of change, you continue to keep us covered. And that we can give you all of our troubles and all of our fears and the unknown. I think that's the biggest concern, the unknown. That we know that we can have faith that you know what our day-to-day is, Lord. So we lift up our friends. We just pray for their covering and their courage that we can find within you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Do you want to pray?
Mm-hmm. You want to pray, Jackson? Go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. Jacob.
Plenty of say to say
okay.
All the time.
Dear God, please let us get
covered and and we love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Good job, Jackson. Thanks. Go ahead, step over. There you go. Oh, my God. Thank you, Jesus. That's so good. So I just want to address something in the room right now, because we're pressing into something a little different, and it might feel awkward. It might be like, where are we going next? What do we do now? Right? I'm just going to encourage you, put your eyes on the Lord. Talk to Him. Say, God, this feels awkward. I don't know what to do. Am I supposed to say something? Do I have a word right now? Do I have a testimony to share? What do you, your Holy Spirit lives in me. What do you want to do right now? You want to heal the sick right now. You want to prophesy right now. So just as we wait on the Lord, I'm just going to encourage you guys. We might just go into worship for a minute or two and just get our eyes back on Him. It's just easy when we're doing something new to get distracted, to get feeling, you know, into feelings. We want to be into the Lord. We want to be into what He's doing right now. So, Father, we commit this into your hand again. Oh, okay. There we go.
Thank you. bodies is shaking, you guys. This is surrender to him every single thing. His arms are open. He's willing to listen. This is such a beautiful song. From the very first time I've heard the song, it broke me. And every time the note hits a high A, like it was literally like a layer just kept coming off and off and off until I had nothing. Until I had nothing. And then I realized I found everything. Because I allowed myself to be so vulnerable. And even right now, I had a dream. Lord speaks to me through dreams. And in the beginning, I wasn't sure what it was until I took it to the Word. And I said, is this even a New Testament thing? Or like, you know, how does this work? And it was only last night that I knew I had a dream for my friends and family, for my church, for you guys, for me too. Because for the first time, I woke up and I didn't have to try to interpret it. I just knew what it was. So I knew it was the Holy Spirit. And I knew that he wants this released. So please bear with me as I speak and as I will try to do it as eloquently as I can. I'm a little bit nervous, but it's a good nervous. It's like a little godly fear because I don't want to mess up. I want to be in obedience to this. So the dream, and as you guys know, we haven't been coming here for a long time, but ever since I stepped foot in this house, my life changed. Yay, Lord. Thank you, God. And so I've read most of New Testament, and not to boast in saying this, but it's so important that we read the Word. It is so important. It is so, so important. And the dream last night woke me up at 7 o'clock this morning, and I knew I was like, write it down because it might come up in church. But I said, Lord, if that's your will, have someone approach me and ask me to do it so that I knew I could release it. Because I'm someone that is very precise and very particular how I do things. And so I don't want to step out of my own strength to do things. And so anyhow, the dream started off in a house. A house with many, many rooms. Very spacious, beautiful place. I walked in and I saw that this house was for us, for me. But it needed different appearance. It needed a different... It had a potential, I'll say that. It had a potential to be fixed up and made very, very beautiful, but yet very simple. So as I began to walk around and I saw a huge window, I began to take off curtains off of the window. I began washing the window. I began washing the floors. I began just rearranging things. And I believe this is all because in my present life, I've been doing that in my own home. And there was a word that was released not long ago, clean house. It is a metaphor how much your soul needs to be ready for something. Even though God is waiting and he's waiting for the house to be ready for him. Remember, a bride without a blemish or a spot. So I was really motivated. And in the dream, as I was taking down old and broken, dusty things, seeing the potential that it had, I began to realize that the room began reviving, renewing, upgrading. Each section of the living space was just so beautiful now. People began coming in that I've never seen. younger kids, like younger generation, like my brothers, and a little bit even younger than him. So I started to walk around in every place, and then I noticed there was a patio, there was a game room, there was a living space. Each drawer was organized in this place, you guys. Every unclean thing, every cabinet was redone. A side house was attached where there was a pool table, a game room, a couch. It all started with the couch. I saw two men discussing something almost like it reminded me of when, correct me if I'm wrong, but when Jesus and on top of the mountain, Moses and Elijah appeared. And it painted a picture in my mind how they would be standing, discussing, or prophesying, or whatever it is that they did in that holy moment. That's what these two men were doing. As I got closer to the younger men that were playing pool, I noticed they were just minding their business. Some were just hanging around in the realm, in the vicinity. But it's not like a person where I would, for example, see our new friend or see Holly, how she's standing, or even Christina. It was a knowing of a presence. It wasn't a physical body per se. So as I decided to sit down, a man sat next to me and he started to read. He had a flyer in his hand, as in he was saying, if anyone has thoughts of suicide, of depression, of sickness, of illness, anything that is addicting, seek help and come to this address. I turned to look at the man. Oh, Lord, thank you for your presence now. As I turned to look at the man, it was my earthly father, who I have no contact with. But it's not him, it's what he represents. And at this point, I allow this man to keep going, but in my spirit, I knew something just, his demeanor when he was kind of saying this wasn't how I said it. It was like more of as a matter of fact. And so as he carried on and kept saying, he said, just go to this address and go to Sveti Ostrog. Now, that's a monastery way back in Serbia, and that's a saint that is recognized as someone that does the healing. In that very second, it was like a ricochet when he said that, I turned to him. I said, no, the only person that can heal all those things is Jesus. I had placed my hand on his like a forearm, and I stood there for a moment, and I smiled. And as I did that, I looked at the other man that was standing. That was my grandfather. And I know that religion is on them, and that is something aside from where I'm headed today. But I just began to realize, as I touched him, my spirit was lifted. I spoke the truth through his Holy Spirit. I stood up and I deviated from that. A table was there in the living space. My brother was sitting on the floor on this table. It's him and I was so excited to tell him, look, I just told, you know, Dad about Jesus, and these people are here. We got to tell them. And it's been tugging on my heart. As we stood up and we started to converse, I looked at the patio where Chad is standing. There's a young man, maybe like 9, 10, 12 years old. He's standing on the edge of the fence, and he's wanting to jump down. As soon as I saw this, I turned around, because at this point, I'm in a different realm. I'm in a different, my mind's not there. My mind is not distracted. As I began to tell my brother what had happened and I started to do, the boy jumped. Again, I didn't have any pool to run. But after I had realized that there was a thump on the ground, we both ran. As I approached down there and I saw four boys, three were laying, as we would call in the medical term, three boys were laying on their back, supine. The fourth boy that had jumped was laying prone. I looked at each three boys, and I said, get up, get up, get up. All three boys stood up. In their disbelief, not knowing where this voice was coming from, I was above them with a bird's eye view. So as I wrap and I tell you the dream and I'll tell you what it means, when I looked at the last little boy, he was covered in a pool of blood. But he was laying this way. I knew I had to do something different. I knew I had to initiate a different spark. I knew I had to pray different for him. I knew I had to press in differently for him because he wasn't laying like the other three boys were. He was laying in a pool of blood, and he was facing down, and it didn't make sense to me. How did that happen? So I said, hey, you, standing next to him, put your hands on him, nudge him, tug at him, allow him to stand. And as I had prayed this, his body flipped over, and he woke up. But before he woke, he took a deep, like, that was God breathing into his soul, into his lungs. Amen. Now, the reason I feel like God really wants me to share this with you guys is because when we allow fear, this ugly thing with its ugly head, fear, it can give the enemy a doorway to something that God is already working. And if you step in thinking that you are doing what God wants you to do and not be obedient to wait, and turn your back just for a moment, trusting that he's going to take care of this no matter what, because of what you carry, because of who you are, and because of what he has put down inside of you. If you give the enemy even a little bit of fear, of knowing that, oh, he's going to jump, I got to yell, I got to shout, I got to stop him, I got to go, I got to grab him. Sometimes you have to let things go and let God. The other thing that spoke to me that the Spirit revealed was when circumstances appear to be in one way, we really have to press into the Word, because the Word will teach us discernment. The Word will teach us how God walked on earth, how he speaks to each soul. He wants us to be sharp. I have verses that I want you guys to, if you're led, because I don't know if this will speak to every heart, but ask God to change the things that you've been around and maybe not even noticing that are clouding, collecting dust, unserving, kind of like that fig tree with Jesus, if you remember. It was just there. Just eating away your soil, your time, your resources, and get rid of it. Clean your eyes like the windows. Let them be shiny. Let them be a lamp, because your eye is the lamp to your soul. Everything that isn't of God, we have to be, we're in a season where we really have to, that's what pressing in is, to say, I will give you what you want. Not what I want, what you want. Give God something to work with, you guys. See Colossians 3, 1 through 25. Please be encouraged by this. And look into the fear of the Lord. This isn't a fear of the enemy. This is a different kind of fear. This is a fear of knowing God is present. He's doing what he's doing. I'm going to step aside. But when he calls me to step up, I'm ready. But it can't happen if you have clouded judgment. It can't happen if you have resentment. It can't happen if you have depression. It can't happen. You have to break loose from that. In Jesus' name. He's already won. He's given us the victory. Yeah. Respect yourself. This is a broken world, but he is perfect. We're just temporary here. This isn't our home. Respect your body. Respect your temple. Respect and honor him. Give him what's his. That's his first commandment. Love him with all your heart.
Hey, can I jump in right here?
Please.
I want you to, I feel like this needs a response. And yeah, no, I want to get to the rest of it. I don't know why that thing's doing that. But, I mean, this is like our favorite song, right? So I want us to respond. And actually, I want you to read. I felt the Spirit of the Lord so strong when you read about the thoughts of suicide and the depression and those type of things, right? And I want you to read those things. And I want us to respond to God. I want us to come to the carpet, to the altar, to the holy place, contend for our breakthrough, and whatever's on your heart, for your family's breakthrough, for the nation's breakthrough, God, and the storm of holiness is going to descend on this place with such power. I believe we need together, as a body, we need to respond to that. And so I just want you to read that little section of the dream again. And you guys just come forward. The flaggers, get your flags. If you want to get on your knees, if you want to pray, however the Lord leads you right now. And let's just respond to this. And let's meet the Lord in this place of holiness. Let's meet the Lord right now. I hear the Lord saying, I sit enthroned upon the praises of Israel. I sit enthroned. Let's make a throne for him right now to come and dwell, to come and deliver, to come and heal, to come and bring the breakthrough,
yes,
to come and give us grace to walk into the new season, to run with him, to run the race, to fight the good fight if we've grown weary.
Yes,
let's
Lord.
Ask him.
Yes, Lord,
so
come.
Go ahead, let's read that.
God says, the Holy Spirit says, if anyone has any thoughts of suicide, depression, sickness, illness, infirmity, any addiction that is keeping you bound, seek his throne. See the beauty of what he's done. Allow yourself to believe that it's already done in the name of Jesus. Release the resentment. Release the unforgiveness. Release your circumstances. Release the doubt. Sit still for a second and listen and feel him on you. Feel him in you. He is longing to be your Savior. He paid the ultimate price for all of us. Holy Spirit, reveal to us what it is that we need to clean house. Help us wash our hands so that they're so clean and pure for you that we can carry glory and healing in them, Lord. And anoint them with your oil so when we touch things that are not of this world, they're not going to be stuck on us. Lord, help us, God. If you can't do it, no one can. We need you. We love you. Just imagine yourself in the heavenly realm. Imagine Jesus standing in front of you, like the man with leprosy or the woman with the blood issue or whatever your circumstances. Allow him. Just touch the garment. Touch the beautiful garment of his. But believe before you even keep pressing and asking. Believe it's done. This world needs us, you guys. This world needs priests, kings, his children to rise. We have to allow it. This place is going to be a place where so many miracles, so much healing, so much brokenness gets revived because of what we carry, because of who we are, because of the authority and the power we have been given by the Lord. I really encourage you right now, in just a few minutes of silence, to reconcile things that are in your soul that you know you have to let go. Repent of what you have to repent. Focus on him, on a man that was 100% man and 100% God, that gave up his royalty for a brief moment to come down to earth and dwell among us. Focus on the most beautiful, radiant smile. When he speaks, he doesn't use words. He uses his spirit to speak to you, but his eyes are love. His smile is love. God is like the eagle. Imagine yourself under his wing, safe, sound, whole, protected, invisible to the enemy. Wherever you go, he will light your steps. He will go before you. He'll show you. He'll teach you. Just ask him. Just ask him and be in a present, in a constant state of peace. The last part of what the Holy Spirit revealed to me was there's this peace. God is a God of peace and order of judgment. God has a certain way of doing things. If we just get to know him in these verses, in this scripture, in this word, and we begin to know what it is that we carry in our temple, we're going to be the lighthouses. We're going to be the lamps. We are going to be so contagious that we're going to be candlesticks lighting every candle around us, you guys. That's his cry right now. He will come back on clouds with his angels. And every knee will bow and every tongue will confess who he is. Let's live like a burning torch for him. Let's press in and not only be hungry, but be thirsty for him. Sing to him in everything. Praise to him in everything. Yes, it might look dark, but you carry the light. He is the light. He is the way. When you stand somewhere, let his glory be so obvious on you. Allow it to come. Allow it to be on you on person at all times so that the darkness has to flee. It has no place there. Allow yourself to fall in love. And as we begin this new year, and as I begin into this new season, and as I begin to learn just about the right way to live with God, how much easier it is his way. And there's so many young people here. I see you guys. And you're like, this lady's probably, what is she talking about? I just encourage you to give yourself the most precious jewel that you can ever find. The most handsome husband that you're going to be the bride to. The most best friend that you can ever imagine. Give him the time, just 10 minutes when you leave this place, and say, I want that. I want to step into that. I want to be a part of that. I want to experience that. I want to feel it. And he so freely gives that all you have to do is be willing. You won't be perfect. I'm not perfect. No one is perfect here. But if we allow ourselves to have the greatest possession, this beautiful treasure, and to realize that each one of us is an instrument in that treasure chest, we begin to see just how glorious God is and how much he can do. So I just thank you, Lord, and I plead your blood over every word I've spoken, Lord. And each one of you has the Holy Spirit. So if it's something I had said that was out of context or out of line for that, use your discernment. I urge you to. I love you, Lord, and I thank you so much for speaking through to this family, Lord. I invite you to stay here. I invite you for people to leave here, and I plead your blood over every single person here. I ask you that when they leave here, they leave changed. That their candle is lit. There's a flame. And nothing can extinguish that fire. I thank you, Lord, for the strength and the encouragement. In Jesus' name, amen.
Son of man with eyes of fire burning, 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 burning. I see seven lamps of fire burning. I see a sea of glass mingled with fire burning. I see the Son of man with eyes of fire burning, burning, burning. Whoa. All around you.
temple cries glory. Everyone in the 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 temple cries glory.
Stay right where they are right now. This is the Lord gave me a word about today. It said the seeds come before the rain, and the rain comes before the harvest. And the thing about seeds is they must die and fall to the ground. And as we finished that song, I look around and a bunch of dead people laying on the ground. Come on. That's it. Where are the seeds? Yes. Right? Yes. Where are the seeds?
Yes.
Jesus. Lazarus was dead. Jesus said, come forth. Maybe God's saying that to you right now. Maybe he's saying it to us. Come forth. Thank you, Jesus.
We give you all.
every voice softly, softly.
You're holy. You're holy. exalted high.
Fill this place, the train of your robe.
And the train of his robe.
Jesus, for your sweet presence in this place. share some of the prophetic message that the Lord had given me for today about this season. And a few years ago, the Lord spoke to me and said, it was totally out of the blue, he said, build an ark that will weather the storm of revival. And I did not understand what that meant. I didn't understand that revival is a storm. It's a purifying storm. And as I was preparing for this message, the Lord showed me a picture of, because it says right before the rain came, the Lord called all the animals into the ark. And I was like, Lord, what are the animals? You know, that doesn't make any sense. He said, the animals are people. I was like, that's interesting. And they, when John the Baptist spoke of the Pharisees, he said, you brood of vipers. So it's a biblical, it's a prophetic theme that animals can be represented as people. And I felt two by two. The Lord was calling his people in. And he's drawing people in. And the next thing he's going to do is he's going to send the rain. Yes. Yes. And there's been years past where the Lord has given us seeds. He's given us promises. Seeds are any word that the Lord has spoken to you. And he's given you these promises, personal promises, corporate promises, whatever area the Lord has spoken to you. And it's been a season of letting those promises die, of letting those things get disconnected from your identity, of realizing that your performance is not going to bring those promises to pass. And coming to today, all of those seeds, however long you've been walking with the Lord, even if you walked with him and walked away and came back, his word doesn't return void. You could have been away from him for 10 years. But that thing that he spoke to you, it still applies. It's not too late. It's not too far gone. And so he said, the ark is built and the rain is coming. And the Lord said, there's been a famine of the word of the Lord, and I'm going to send the rain. And I got excited about that. Because the word of the Lord is going to spring up from the ground, and the earth's going to be covered with the knowledge of the glory of God. And we're going to get to be a part of that. He's going to let us be a part of that. So whatever God's done in your life up to this point, whatever words he's spoken to you, however you know him, now it's time to reproduce that. And as we're going forward, a season of rain is a season of fruit and harvest. And as we spoke in these last few weeks, we talked about evangelism and reaching the lost and all of those things. And I believe the Lord spoke to me and said, actually it's in Genesis 1, he said, I made all the trees bearing fruit in their season, in which is their seed. So where does the seed of evangelism come from? It comes from the fruit of the Holy Spirit. So if we are going to multiply, if we are going to evangelize, if we are going to, if God's going to bring people, it's not going to be us going out trying to sow seed. it's going to be us going out bearing fruit. And people are just going to eat the fruit. They're just going to eat it. And when they eat it, they're going to get the seed. And they're going to be like, what is that? I want some more of that. That's good. Oh, you're not going crazy with all this stuff that's going on. You're like full of joy in your life. Like, what is that about? They're going to be amazed. They're going to be shocked that you're not consumed with the political drama or social media drama or financial drama or relational drama or whatever. You're not going to be overtaken by that because you're going to be walking in the Spirit of God, bearing much fruit. And that's encouraging to me. Because then it's not about what I got to do for God. It's about what God's going to do through me. And man, can I just confess? I have no idea what to do next. But that's so good. And I was being tempted during that last worship song to, like, fear man. I was being tempted to, like, all right, let's wrap it up. We've been going for a while. You know, maybe people are getting hungry. Maybe they're tired. I was being tempted in that way. And I don't think we're done yet. I don't know what's next, but God put it on my heart to heal the sick. That's two witnesses. And as Pastor Andrew, he was wrapped in the flag during worship, and he was covered by the lion. And if anybody has sickness or physical pain in their body, I just want to invite you up. Maybe we can just clear out the front row, and or if you don't want to come up, we can come to you. And I want to have Pastor Andrew wave the flag over whoever's sick. And while he's waving the flag and we got the worship music, maybe you and I, since the Lord was both speaking to us about healing, we're just going to pray. And I believe God wants to heal people. And so if you want to stand in place for someone or if you just, the thing that was on my heart was like lower back pain and if you have one leg that's shorter than the other, if there's anybody in that situation. Any physical physical sickness, depression, mental cloudiness, you know, those kind of things. We just want to invite you, and maybe we'll just bring some chairs up here. George, you want to help me get about maybe 3, 4, 5 chairs, and we'll just put them on the carpet here. Yeah, we'll just get a couple. Just maybe 3 or 4. Yeah, face in the front. Yeah, that's good. Just get one more. Yeah, perfect, Rob. Thanks. That should be plenty. Maybe one more. George, you got one more? Okay. Good deal. Yeah, right down here. Perfect. We're good. All right. And as we're praying for the sick, if you're not sick or you don't have pain in your body or you're not requesting prayer, I ask that right now you be praying for those who are praying, right? Because I want to keep everyone engaged in this. This is still a family thing. If you want to pace, you know, if you want to walk, if you want to stretch your hands out, I just ask that you would be praying for us who are praying. If you feel led to pray and lay hands, please come forward and join us in that. I'm going to turn the microphone off. It'll be a little bit more personal. I got fasting breath, so I'm sorry in advance. But, Cindy, you can go ahead and just turn the worship up just a little bit. And this is just going to be a time where I believe God touches his people and comes to minister to us. So, Father God, we just commit this time to you. We just trust in you now. We don't want to leave your presence. We want to be made whole in your presence right now in every way, spiritually, physically, financially, in our soul, in our mind, in our body. Breakthrough right now. We declare the breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Father, we just thank you for your mercy, God, and we ask for your leadership and your guidance through this process, and that you would heal bodies right now in the name of Jesus. Amen.
All right. Oh, I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else would do. Nothing else, nothing else, oh, nothing else will do. Coming back to what really matters. Just want to bless your heart, Jesus. Just want to bless your heart, Jesus. You're all that matters, Jesus. You're all that matters, Jesus. Coming back to what really matters. Just your heart, Jesus. Bless your heart. I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else. I just, nothing else, nothing else. Nothing else will do.
voice arise.